Atari's successful coin-op game. There isn't much to know about Circus Atari.
Oh, it's crackly. Gosh. One of these days. I was just doing this to test audio, actually. One moment. Just gotta do the little whoopsie-doo. Gotta do a little swapperoo. There we go. Okay. How's it going, everyone? Corn on the cob. Star Wars dolls aren't selling well. That means they're going to be rare in 20 years. Oh, I mean then. Yeah, I wonder how the reception of episode 9 and 8 have affected Star Wars merch. Because they, didn't they not release any toys for episode 8 right up until released? Seems like they did it to avoid spoilers, actually, which... kind of an interesting thing. Everyone likes to yell at Disney for being soulless and assholes, but they probably lost a lot of money to do that just to preserve surprises for people, so. Or they do that for every film? Or they don't launch toys until the day of? What's up, MCMK? How were the tacos? Well, there's only one taco. It was more the dregs from a taco salad. So it was vegetable rice that Stephanie put, like, Mexican spice into, which was delicious, and then some ground beef. Basically, I made a leftover bowl. Made an event for every film called Force Friday that's X weeks before release. And there were waves released after the movie is out. Interesting, okay. Were they still doing Force Friday? Mm-hmm. Thank you, Undercooked. The spice of my people. Alright, Tatooine. Don't get to play Coruscant. All the way up to 9. Okay. Probably not gonna crash this time. So, as I think we've slowly learned, the game starts to fall apart in stages. Step one is the background music stops playing. Strong opening from Plo Koon. Oh, I meant to bring this up. Oop. Sorry there, Anakin. Ah, he's fine. He's fine. Everyone's fine. Oh, they can't hit him. Okay. I started watching Clone Wars, which means I now know what Plo Koon's canon voice is. And I've been workshopping it a little bit. Been working on my Plo Koon voice. So here we go. Man. Yeah, I'm Plo Koon. I'm a Jedi. I was workshopping that all night last night, so I think I'm pretty close to how he sounds in the show. Just took a little tweak, really. Didn't take that much. I was shockingly close to begin with, but I didn't know he was a Jedi Master. Also, I didn't know Obi-Wan was a Jedi Master during the Clone Wars. I thought he was just a Jedi Knight. Plo Koon has been my favorite Jedi for a long ass time. He's epic. He's on the council? Oh, okay. Well, I guess... So does that mean that Obi-Wan was on the council? They are both in the council in episode 1. What do you mean by both? I don't know, man. I didn't pay attention to the fucking council. There's like... I only cared about Mace Windu. Oh, he can use his own version of Force Lightning? That's pretty sick. You can join Clone Wars? Only Jedi Masters were generals as far as I know. Hmm. Became Master during the 2D Clone Wars after Anakin was knighted. Oh, that was in the 2D show. Okay, interesting. I don't remember that one. I gotta go back and watch the 2D show then, maybe. Oh, hey, Siphol Ken. Watching from Malaysia? That's pretty cool. The show is already a lot better than, So it's interesting. On retrospect, I can finally kind of get to the bottom of what my past was in my history with, Clone Wars. Sorry, just tweaking audio. So, when I watched Clone Wars back in the day, I don't think it was a movie back then. I'm pretty sure it was a three-part miniseries that has since been bundled into a movie. It's the, it's the movie where they have to, Anakin and Ahsoka have to go to Tatooine to save Jabba the Hutt's child. And it's just wretched. It might be the worst Star Wars thing I've ever seen. And I thought that that's how the Clone Wars show started. But it doesn't. The Clone Wars show starts with, like, Yoda doing some shit. That movie is so epic. No, it is not. No, it's not. It's actually not. That movie's horrible. It is really bad. It's really, really bad. There's a couple of scenes in it that are cool. The part where, like, Anakin and Ahsoka are on the walkers as they're, like, climbing vertically on a mountain face. That was kind of neat. Everything else was just wretched. Just the worst. Oh, yeah. Jabba's sister, yeah, I think it was nephew, who speaks English and is on Coruscant? Okay. Yeah, oh, sorry, the show. Yeah. So, it's weird, because I swear that was part of the show. Oh, Clone Wars aired out of chronological order? I thought so. Yeah, Zero the Hutt. The gay one? Yeah, kind of has a lisp. Also, there's a shot where Zero's like, trying to make away as the clones are raiding Zero's fortress, and it's just like, the slowest, like, run you've ever seen. And Zero only gets to, like, a corner of the room. They're like, stop! And then, it's, oh, God, it's so worse. Oh, sorry, Arabesh. Yeah, Galactic Common or whatever. I'm watching them in release order or chronological? Release order. The only thing that was a little weird is, yeah, episode one just kind of goes in the middle of shit. Which was a little odd. But it's fine. I'm enjoying it so far. Ow. Forgot this part. Hey, Mortal Kombat. Would resetting between levels be an option to reset your freezing issue? I mean, we'll find out, Lick. That's the strat that I'm gonna go with. Once the sound starts breaking down, I'll quit the game and restart it. Oh, Tegzay? So yeah, That was my perception of the show, was that shitty three-parter. I thought it was a miniseries. So I never watched the show proper. And it's already tons better. There's been some pretty cool episodes, some pretty decent writing. It goes shockingly pretty hard about, like, death. There was that scene with, like, with the clones that were in an escape pod, and there were, like, droids going around and basically just poking holes in the other escape pods and showed it, like, depressurizing and ejecting clones out into space. I'm like, dang, man. That's pretty sick. So, yeah, I understand that the clone, or people have said the Clone Wars show goes pretty hard in the paint on some space battles and stuff, so I'm excited. Yeah, Zach, I mean, that's pretty cool. I wonder how hard they're gonna hit that in the show of, like, the Jedi actually care about the clones. So, we'll see. I'm already kind of... My defense mechanisms have already activated a little bit. If they're gonna keep hammering this, Ahsoka becomes my favorite Star Wars character. Oh my gosh. She is so horridly wretched in the miniseries. Because they do that thing. They do that thing that all, like... fiction that's meant to appeal to young adults do, where she consistently whines that she's not being listened to, and she's just, man, she's just awful. And it, like, but like, all the cool characters in the show like are unreasonably tolerant with her, and then they learn to accept her because she's actually smart the whole time, and her ideas were actually good, and blah 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 blah. And maybe adults should listen to kids every now and then. I'm just bleh. But yeah, she's already much better in the show. It doesn't help that, like, within, like, 5 minutes, she's already, like, coming up with stupid nicknames for Anakin, and it's just makes you want to crawl out of your skin like a snake. But yeah, I understand she gets a lot better. Yeah, no, Trey, I've heard Plo Koon's official voice now. Yeah, Sky Guy. I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? That's the worst. It's not even a good nickname. God, it's awful. And she's just like, just fucking, just snarking about everything. Shut up. You've heard one of the official voices? He's had like three different voices? Interesting. Okay. Well, the first one is pretty buttery. I gotta admit, I wasn't expecting smooth, rich tones to come out of a man with no mouth. Oh, Clone Wars is all the same? Okay. Anakin's much more annoying? Then Ahsoka? I don't know about that. Not yet, anyway. The movie was released in theaters, not a miniseries. Really? That's so weird. I did not know it came out in theaters. I'm trying to remember how I watched it then. Because I remember watching it, like, in my apartment when I was in college. And I went, bleh, and I just shut it off, like, two-thirds of the way through. So it was interesting watching the end of it. Oh, you saw it in theater? Okay. Then, man, I don't know what's going on then. Maybe I just download. Yeah, Mandela Effect, maybe. I probably just pirated it back in the day. It sucked shit. Yeah, it's real bad. But, like, almost immediately I'm like, you know what? I'd be super into this series. At least in the first couple episodes, I really like that each episode is, like, a literal and direct continuation from the last. And the space battles are pretty legit in the show. And this is season one. And people say it gets way, way better. So I'm excited to keep watching it. The movie was the series premiere. Okay. So I guess that's what... I must have, like, tried to watch it. And that, like, just turned me off to the entire series. I was like, if this entire series is just going to be... like Ahsoka mouthing off like a broody teen and then getting patted on the head for being an annoying ass. No thank you. But apparently it's not that. So that's good. Season 1 is a kid's show compared to the rest? Damn, man. There's already some crazy shit going down. And yeah, I did see the comment that like the clone stuff gets to Nier Automata territory. Like, do they have souls? Are their lives valuable, etc., etc.? It was weird to go back and remember, like, it took so long for the visibility of, like, clone troopers versus droids to feel like Star Wars to me. It felt so much just like, I don't know. It didn't feel the same for the longest time, but I guess now that enough time has passed, it does feel like Star Wars. To watch it chronologically makes the narrative much more rewarding. Eh. I'm sure I'll... I'm sure I'll get close enough to the same experience. I do remember, like, somebody referenced the character Fives before. I can't remember what it... I think, is Fives in a Republic Commando or something? I remember Fives was in something, and somebody was like, hey, I know that character, and I was like, I never heard of them. But then I saw the episode where they established Fives. So that was cool. And it is pretty wild, though, because they have, like, full-on... they have full-on conversations with multiple clones, and they all have kind of the same voice. And the bass voice isn't even really that expressive, so it is kind of interesting how they can... how the voice actors, or voice actor, or there might only be one clone voice actor, has to, like, just very so subtly change intonation for different characters. Growing up with the prequels and Icy Clones and Droids, and it's never not been Star Wars. Yeah, it's interesting. I remember even playing the Old Republic and feeling like that game didn't feel like Star Wars for a very long time to me. Knights of the Old Republic. Oh, D. Bradley Baker? Oh, that's him? Okay. People make Clone Wars really love Star Wars and it shows. Maybe it does eventually. Oh! This part sucks. Because, yeah, boy. The thing is, okay, so... the thing that I think is most damning about the, here's something that super pissed me off. At the end of the Clone Wars movie. Is, they do all this shit, right? And, like... or maybe it was at the end of one of the episodes. No, it was at the end of the movie. Where, like, Dooku's talking to Palpatine, and they're like, well, they won this time. And then Palpatine's like, oh, the tides of the war are turning in our favor. I'm like, what do you mean? You guys are both sides. It doesn't matter who wins or loses because you've already won. What does this mean? What does this dialogue even mean? I swear, it's like they forgot that the war is fake. I don't know, man. That just read super weird to me. I'm like, did you forget that they're actually working together? Dooku thinks the Separatists are supposed to win the war? Why does it matter? And why would he think that? He's not that stupid. His master controls the Republic. Yeah, the Republic's gonna win. That doesn't make any sense to me. Lightsaber go brrr. I mean, yeah, that's the Jay Rickle. That's the appropriate response to any of this. I mean, I think that's like, I do appreciate that the show really drills into like showing the. I took that to mean between the Sith and the Jedi. I mean, he said that in direct relation to the events of the battle that just happened, which had nothing to do with the Sith and the Jedi. They explained that in like season 4. Oh, really? Oh man. Okay. What a politically charged stream. Hey, that's the prequels, baby. What do you mean? These streams celebrate the prequels, and because of that. We're gonna talk nothing but politics, so I hope you're ready for that. Master never shared his full plan with anybody? Yeah, but Dooku's not stupid. Maybe he is, but... He still knew the war was a construct. That was part of the plan. That much was revealed in episode 2. So, like... God fucking goddamn! Holy shit. What's up, Zany Ahmad? The movie takes place between the latter half of season 1 and season 3. It's a mess of no context. I mean, yeah, no, that makes sense to me. I mean, the context should be that they both know that the war is not real. So, like, what side wins doesn't matter? Yeah! Fucking Christ, this is so dumb. This part is so stupid. Yeah. There we go. There. Whew. Seems like a rage quit kind of level. Yeah, imagine having to do it twice because the game crashed. Imagine that. God. How awkward would it have been though for Palpatine if Anakin didn't kill Dooku? Well, he would have just continued on with Dooku. That's the Sith way, right? You just, through the process of natural selection, you ensure that you always have the strongest master and the strongest apprentice. Okay. Yeah, I need to send a letter to the devs. Look at all these bullets. If one of them hits me in the air, I die instantly. Huh? Okay. Yeah, Johnny Uppercut. I think my timer's usually around 2 stages. So if I can probably beat... This is too much to type. Zach, you trying to bang out an article for me? I actually appreciate this, because I know that I have a chat full of Clone Wars scholars, which is wonderful. Fuck! Huh. Yeah, they're firing physical bullets at me, which means no deflecting. Okay, the hard part's done. What's up, Mark? Mark Brophy? Just finished a final and I feel unstoppable? Hell yeah, Deacon, sir. Slam a white claw and headbang until you get a headache. Fucking Christ. How many Jedi do you play as in this? Well, there's 5 on the selection screen. But each one is like its own progression file, so... You don't like rotate through characters as you go through levels. Ow. Yeah, not quite dead. There's a lot. Oh! Okay, well, there we go. There's a lot of stuff in this game that's not fair. Like, instant death pits being just off screen. You just happen to run directly into them. There's also, like, a scoring mechanic that... Fuck off! The hit stun is pretty brutal. The scoring mechanic is interesting because you actually get character upgrades based on your score at the end of the level. But, like, your score persists across credits. So, if you want to score attack, it's almost like you have to clear out a checkpoint, intentionally die, and then reload so you can farm points. Because it doesn't really factor in how many lives you have left and your ranking. Ugh. The probe droids can kill Tusken Raiders? Those aren't probe droids, my friend. Those are Darth Balls. I really have no idea what the... Yeah, these... The... Ugh! Off-camera jumps. Platforming with, projectiles that make you drop like a rock if they hit you. Well, at least I got that twirl. So here, there's a part later where you have to, like, escort Anakin... There's that cup noodle that apparently just does, like, random effects. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's what took down Chirrut Imwe, right? Although he wasn't a Jedi. He had the power of Asian mysticism. God damn it. Yeah. Is that a credit? It is. Okay. Oh, Thread the needle? I should have threaded the needle. That actually gave me health. Shockingly. Anakin seems to have a point with killing Tusken Raiders. That's why people didn't freak out too much when he slaughtered a bunch of them. Yeah. I mean, they're considered savage, right? I don't know, I think the point of that was to demonstrate that he certainly had the capacity to lose himself to his passion. And also that he had just a truckload full of mom issues that he never dealt with. Benicio Del Pollo, thank you for the resub. Yeah, people didn't notice. It's weird to me that Padme didn't seem to mind all that much. She's okay, what? That's kind of a big old red flag. When your boyfriend freaks out and slaughters an entire village. I mean, even if they were like... Even if you consider them like wild animals. If your boyfriend came home like covered in blood and is like, I may have just killed like 200 cats. Yeah, right? She handled that with a remarkable aplomb. Padme was kind of dumb as shit in the movies, yeah. They wrote in all these token scenes for her to seem as tough as Leia. Like, it feels like they really tried to work that angle, but it didn't come across as well as they wanted, I don't think. Which is why it's interesting in, oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm reminded now, there was that scene in Clone Wars in Season 1 where they're pursuing Grievous, and then Padme just shows up and gets immediately abducted. And, like, there's one line of, like, what is she doing here? And then that's it. She's just, hey, Anakin, I'm here. Oh, my God! In the movie, at least, they tried to, like, write in some stuff where she was flexing her diplomatic power, but geez. Okay. She needed his semen for her senator abilities. For forced diplomacy. She brought him lunch? How could she have been as cool as Leia? I mean, she can't, is the answer. But I mean, I think the idea was to try and show that spirit reflected in her. They even gave her Leia hair a little bit in episode 2. And they tried to do it in the show, too, as I recall. Padme going from queen to senator was always weird to me, too. So did Babu elect a 13-year-old? Naboo. And yeah, I don't remember. I remember at one point I knew the Nabooian rite of succession or whatever, why she was such a young queen, but... Yeah, why is she as fat as Leia? Been enough time. Didn't we get her young enough so she wouldn't be fat? I've seen the virus episode, no. I'm only like 4 or 5 episodes into season 1. She doesn't seem to mind a lot of things. Like, love... Being an elite cult of space wizards who are, by tradition, supposed to be loners? Huh. Story group is super consistent? What do you mean, story group? This Jedi looks about the same amount of jank as Jedi Fallen Order? What? Oh man, if you think the two are even remotely comparable in terms of jank... I don't know, Coonster, I encourage you to pick up a controller and try to play this game. There is really no comparison. Mr. Nutty seems to be asking the real cues here. Wait, hold on. How many Midichlorians are there in one load of Anakin's splooge? Probably a lot. More than any other Jedi. Yoda laugh at you? Yeah, I've been picking up a lot of Yoda giggles. All of Dathomir and Fallen Order just feels so janky. Dathomir was a little more maze-like. I don't like that there's a shadow up there. You know about the prequel game we play, so Obi-Wan do constant backflips? I need to, I'm gonna play it eventually, yeah. It's just called Star Wars Obi-Wan, I'm pretty sure. I'm real excited. So, for everyone asking about other Star Wars games, or prequel games specifically, I am playing this because it's part of a Star Wars prequel-thon! Where I'm playing, going to try to play at least, every video game that I can find based off of the Star Wars prequel movies. Right now I'm doing that sourced off of a list of Star Wars video games that I found, but there are apparently some plug-and-play Star Wars games that I gotta buy. So, it's gonna be a fun journey. I'm learning a lot, really immersing myself in Star Wars. It kind of feels to me like the prequels were when the Star Wars engine was running its hottest. Like, the most merch, the most transmedia stuff. Because the originals were great, but the spin-offs were like, they were, you know, whatever. Like the Ewok movies or the Star Wars special. There wasn't a whole lot else in terms of like... Like, there were a ton of video games, sure. There weren't like knockoff series or anything like that. This include arcade games. Maybe. I mean, they probably run on MAME, so sure. What prequel-based Star Wars games are there? Because there's like Star Wars Arcade, which is awesome, but you know, you can beat it in like 20 minutes. Pod Racer was an arcade game? Oh, that's true, it was. Well, I played Racer, but it was the PC version. Yeah, you... For everything I think George Lucas is kind of justifiably criticized for about maybe being a disjointed director and maybe not the best writer and maybe not the best at like getting the best performance out of his actors and all that stuff. You gotta respect the man's business acumen for sure. Oh, there's a second Podracer game. What's the name of it? Okay. Nitro's done the math. He has a midichlorian count of at least 20,000 per cell. One ejaculation contains at least 40 million sperm. Therefore, the load must contain at minimum 800 million midichlorians. Ooh, okay. Pod Racer 2, the second lap. Yeah, that's right. It was called, Racer Revenge. Who's revenging? Why are we revenging? Okay, Racer Revenge. Alright, I'll have to... That's not on my list for some reason. I'll have to track that down. stomps, and then he roar. Great. Very good. And then he flips. Comes over here. Oh. Oh. Yeah, this is absolutely the Dodongo fight. Battlefront 2 campaign? The Battlefront campaign is not great. I remember trying to play it. It's just a bunch of bot matches, right? There's really nothing else in it? God damn. Ah! You want to talk about jank? Man. Try needing to manually line up your attacks with a D-pad. To hit an enemy with a very large hitbox. God! Yeah, swing and a miss. I think I've got one hit on him so far. He comes this way. And then he should growl. There we go. Also, attacks move you forward. So you have to, like... Yeah, that's how we did it. No dual shock. I'm doing it! I'm doing it in 2020, goddammit! Oh, I hear him screaming. I'm not over there. Music's still playing, though, so we're in the green. I'm gonna flip. Oh, rocks. Yeah, and then he rolls. He's gonna roll into the lava in the middle, and then you get a new heart container? I wish. God damn it. God damn you. Don't... Okay, he's rocks. I have to be close to him so that he does the flip and run. Otherwise, he'll just slap the ground and make rocks appear. Ugh. Jin fought the Mudhorn? Yeah, it's totally like that. And like your little Peepo pants. God bless Peepo. This fight is like sand. It's annoying, it gets everywhere. The desert takes everything from you. Hate the desert. Hate sand. What about fan-made games? And by that, if I make a game, will you play it? I will. I will, as long as it's about Plo Koon jacking off in a Target bathroom. This fight's like a Tusken Raider, they just keep dying all over the place. Missed! Missed! Ugh. Used to be Peepo Gun on here. Ow! Got hit by a rock there. Born and the Peepo Gun. You merely adopted it. I hate this. I hate when he runs here. Because it's so far away, it's really hard to tell where his fucking hitbox is. Ow! Okay. Oh, there we go. The Tiger Star Wars games? Oh, like the handheld LCD games? Or the, like... Because somebody mentioned the, like, plug-and-play ones for the TV. So I can do those. Wait, that guy disappeared. That's not a good sign. Oh, I mean, I'm sorry, what is... I got a bad feeling about this. Somebody has said that in basically every episode of, Clone Wars so far. Droids have said it, Anakin said it. Star Wars! Thinking about that Red Letter Media video. Which I think was unfair, because they did it about Rogue One. And that's probably the most legitimate, like, Star Wars movie. Maybe it's deserved, I don't know. What's wrong with your face? I don't know. I'm smiling? Maybe that's the problem. I'm on the internet and I'm not scowling or screaming about something. I'm enjoying a fun Star Wars video game. Yeah, if there are Tiger prequel-based games, I gotta play them. You got me concerned now, No, face looks fine. Me, anyway. Yeah, the Red Letter Media thing. Oh, sorry. I did not. So let's... Alright, so I missed the reference, that's something. But let's put it like this, alright? Let's say it like this. You can't reasonably be annoyed if somebody doesn't catch your reference if all you're doing is bashing out a normal English sentence in Twitch chat. I'm not gonna sit by and let people roll their eyes at me on twitch.tv for that. No, not allowed. Oh, I know you're not upset. I'm just having some fun. That's it. Just getting a little wild on the internet. Let my hair down. No big deal. Hey, it's no big deal. Hey, no big deal. Great. Well, he's on a plane I can no longer touch, so you get to survive. Yes, Johnny, that is the only thing you're allowed to roll your eyes about. I love it when he says wizards. Run, tell them to take off. That's not Plo Koon. I'm Plo Koon. Wow, that doesn't even hit. Oh, look, these points I'm getting off this guy. I'm getting really wired on this sick lightsaber fight. Oh yeah, Giggle, I played through Dark Forces 2 again the other day. It was awesome, man. I love that game. But I was glad to get a playthrough of it done so I can uninstall it and not fret over mods anymore. Now I kinda wanna see what mods are available for Jedi Outcast. Oh, that's it! Zoriya! Oh. There we go. I did it. Oh wait, there was more health. Whatever. Are we... Okay! It seriously is just a memory leak. The game actually just degrades and crashes if you play it too long. Oh, it's your first time on Twitch, Tonic Toaster? Okay. Definitely feel free to ask if you're confused about anything. I know Twitch can be a little weird. Dun 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 dun. Always health. Do all copies do that, or just this install? Well, it's not installed. I have heard at least one other person be like, "Oh yeah, my game did that too." I've only ever heard one other person like validate it, and I haven't seen any posts online about it. Then again, this game predates the internet. No, it doesn't. But almost. First time on Twitch, let's keep talking about Anakin's cum. Aw, thanks for gifting a sub. It's very kind of you. Thank you, Sixon.
Overcome the mercenaries who wish to stop you from reaching the Temple of the Jedi.
Why am I going to the Temple of the Jedi? I thought I was redoing the beats of episode 1. Which means I'm gonna... This is the episode where you go back to the, Wait, is there... There's a Jedi Temple? Yeah, there is a Jedi Temple in Coruscant. All right. If you want to be technical, a lot of games do not predate the internet. That's true. That's true. Yeah. Now you are the one to kill the younglings. Is that a Greedo? I think he's a green doe. Jedi Temple? Why, what did I say? Hey! Uh-oh. I have not played Obi-Wan, no, chip aside, but that is in the prequel game queue. It will be played. Usually when you get close enough, these dudes just start throwing hands. Ow, okay. They're like gun-ready, posture's getting faster. It's kind of interesting. Wonder if I can break these for points. Nope. Yeah, finally the Rodians have taken over the Jedi Temple. They claimed their birthright. Listen, Coruscant's a rough place. Oh my Christ! Woo!
Melko Dong Juba! Melko Yamachiya! Melko Dong Juba! Yamachiya!
It's like dropping kung fu moves on me. Holy shit. Oh, I get tossed out of this level so many times. Oh boy. Alright, well. That's like episode 2! Now, all that needs to happen is for one random bolt to fly out of the car, and then I'll just, drop my lightsaber. Cool! This is cool! Fighting dudes on top of cars? Hell yeah. Hell yeah. This game gets more confusing by the minute? What do you mean? Makes sense to me. This guy's a little thicker. Don't remember Rodians attacking the Jedi Temple? Yeah, I think it was a deleted scene. You can really think of this game as the director's cut of episode 1. Never got this far ever? Yeah, I don't think most people did. This is the whole point of this stream, okay? I'm basically like your older brother. You call me in and I beat the video game for you. You got too many things to do. You got a busy day. You got a lot going on in your life. Let me beat the video games for you. Go back to, I don't know, making out with girls or whatever it is you do. Well? It feels like that door should have opened. Never beaten this game legitimately? Yes, Aaron X. You live through me. I give you permission to. Oh, I guess I'm over here. Okay. I'm slowly learning this game's visual language. See, that's an element of jank that is, you can't really compare to something like Fallen Order. This game doesn't always do the best job signposting you about where you're supposed to go. Sometimes it'll be off camera, and you just have to kind of push the boundaries and see what texture looks a little bit off. Uh-huh. I don't watch Kunguna Sura yet? I'm not familiar with that. I'm gonna go for a bike ride? Nice. Yeah, get some fresh air, man. Explore the world. Yamachiya. So many times this stream I'll start typing correct Star Wars misinformation and I'll look and see and written like 12 lines and just delete it all. No, Zach, do not do that. I give you permission to post as many Star Wars books as you like. I'm frustrated at this point that there's Star Wars lore that you could have been educating me on and are choosing not to. It's not worth it? What do you mean? What in this life is worth it? Looked up prequel handhelds, two pod racing ones and a new Naboo fighter one, a lightsaber one where you swing it around, and the Naboo Jedi fight one where you put the figures on the D-pad. Uh-oh. So, like, crap. I mean, if I have to buy, like, a gang of toys to even play a game, that might be a little too far. Thought about fighting the headache, but then decided to give in to science because it feels like the type of headache that can go real bad, and I have shit to do. Musashi, from experience, I can say that's the right call. Every time I've felt a headache coming on, and I've just been like, it's not so bad. Maybe it'll just go away. It never does. And in fact, it gets much, much worse, to the point where I get incapacitated. So, yeah. I'm usually, like... there are a lot of medication ads that will really try and, like, espouse the second you feel anything, you should take some stuff. Because, of course, they want you to do that. But, for headaches, at least with the way my body goes, I've started to learn the signals and to not talk myself out of taking something. Because I've gotten into a bad position a lot. By trying to just suck it up. See? Nitro's doing it. Nitro's in the spirit of prequel Thursday, or whatever. What's a... guys. And it's confirmed to have a sperm count of 26 million shortly after leaving Naboo for the Siege of Mandalore, where he piped Padme so good he put two babies in her. And they were both even more powerful than he was. Specifically, Leia. Because let's be honest, we never really did get a good Luke versus Vader showdown. I guess he did chop his arm off, but... Vader was already a little compromised at the time. I think Padme's just very fertile? Maybe. I mean, she's probably also never had sex before, so... Whatever the version of blue balls is for ovaries, that's probably what she had going on. Her baby maker was fucking raring to go. Just sitting there all dusty. Yeah. Magenta ovary. Blue walls? Oh shit. Rick? You've done it. You've absolutely done it. That's the best thing I've ever heard. Isn't that what menstruation is? Menstruation is the opposite. Menstruation is like nature's punishment for not getting knocked up. Yeah, we're done. Close the book on that one. We found the perfect term. Yamachiya. Ooh, that was close. Is that another card? Oh, okay. God damn it. I mean, it was another card, but... Called Blue Ovaries? That's not bad. I mean... Don't let... Well, I know dudes love kind of labeling things for ladies. Don't allow me to tell you what it's like when the baby-making engine kicks into high gear, but... Blue balls for men is cummy aches. Ooh, I like that. I like that a lot. That's really good. I think of it less as punishment, more of a monthly backflushing of the filters. Yeah. I tend to, while I know that human society has long liked to associate punishment just for the sake of being female, it sure does feel like sometimes, nature has it out for women. Cummy aches is good because you know your girlfriend would get pissed off to hear it. I mean, I don't think a lot of girlfriends like hearing about blue balls either, because the implications are a little unsavory. The whole like I'm in discomfort because of something you did and now it's your responsibility to fix it. That's just gross. But so yeah, nature is more out for gamers than women because, if you think about it, if nature weren't prejudiced against gamers, then we would get super ripped just by sitting here and playing video games. But instead, we get fat. We get fat and our bodies break down because we sit and play video games all day. What the hell is that? Just more proof that gamers have to deal with way more prejudice than any other marginalized group on the planet. What other group? Huh? What other group? Besides maybe Americans. Get fat just because they're living their culture. You know? But we here as gamers, we live our culture every day and nature says, no, you get heart disease. No, you get fucking blood clots and thromboids and shit. Not fair. We need the medical community to end this harassment of gamers. Also, yeah, just women. Women have tons of parts that sure do love to get cancer. I mean, dudes do too. I guess we got that prostate, but... Again, that's not even fair! Like, women gotta do pap smears and shit, while guys get their buttholes fingered? Again, it's not fair. Dudes get to go in and have their G-spot rubbed to see if they have cancer or not. Women have to have their titties slammed in a vise, or have shit scraped out of their vagina. How is that fair? Like, oh, hold on, let me check if you have clitoral cancer. And I just rub you off for 5 minutes. Nope, you're all good. Thanks, Doc! You guys high-five and that's it. That's what it's like for a dude. Pfft. Not fair, man. Not fair. This is a universal topic. I agree. As usual, we're hitting on the real big brain thoughts here. Somebody just stapled some shit onto the back of this Darth ball and called it a day. Another for the weird shit Lawrence says, Pyle. Pretty much. It's true, though! Dude! Ask a woman who's ever had a pap smear how fun that shit is. And then relish- oh boy, yeah, these guys are gonna- These guys are gonna chuck me into the void if I'm not careful. It's not great. I wouldn't imagine. It sounds terrible. Yeah, any ladies in chat want to talk about getting your vagina scraped? Not in the good way either. Cervical smears aren't fun. All right. There, see, we're learning. Guess whose wife had her uterus fingered to try and induce birth? What? Is that a... Wait, hold on. How do you even get fingers in there? That seems like an infection waiting to happen. Hey, Lou Dudette, thank you for the resub. They try to break the waters manually? Wow! That's metal! That's raunchy, man. That's like some kind of Greek birth myth. That's kind of equivalent to somebody having a headache and a full-grown woman spitting out of someone's head. It's like, yeah, I reached up into your mom and massaged her ovaries so that you would explode out of a liquid sack. Medical fisting. Man. Imagine that. Your wife's like, honey, I need you to do something. One Google search later and you're scrubbing all the way up to your elbows in the kitchen sink, being like, I can't believe what the fuck I'm about to do. Is he like seriously talking shit? He's like goading me on? Yeah, he's like, give it to me! What you got, son? Stretch and sweep. Interesting. This seems like I'm gonna slide as soon as I stand on it. And I am, okay. How dare you! This fucking video game! Putting a little laser ball right there. Oh, Scarbo? Can't see the- wait, get to the parts where you have to slide on rooftops? I think I just got there. You ever think about how a good majority of the human population has sucked their mother's titties? Of course! I have! I think that's why everyone has some kind of appreciation of a nice titty. Because that's where your nourishment came from for like the first year of your life. I mean, if you're weird. The first 8 years if you're not weird. If you're totally normal. It gets worse, I'm so sorry. I'm gonna do it. Don't worry. I'm gonna do it. Again, big brother energy here. What is that? I need that health. Alright. And you can always tell a tit. This part is hell. I mean, I guess they kind of prepared me for it in the last episode. Or the last level. I didn't expect this to be a gameplay or a level design element that they would really run with. Well, the vibrator invented to help women with hysteria. I mean, I think maybe incidentally. I think it was mostly electroshock and cornflakes, but those might be urban myths for all I know. This is an interesting thing. Is it gonna blow me up? Let's find out. Oh, okay. Oh yeah, and then they have the flippy boys here. Yeah. Okay, alright. Be safe. Shoot another laser, you bitch. Do you actually like reload it? Looked like it was a muzzle loading rifle or something. Oh. This dude's attack strat is awesome. What if you ignore the provoking ones? There's an incentive to kill enemies, because the points amount to character upgrades. At least it says it does. I gotta be honest, it doesn't really feel like I have significantly more health than I started the game with. Deadfist, good luck, Lawrence. My internet sucks here. Talk to you next time. I'm sorry to hear that, man. I wish that you had good internet, so that we could hang out. This is pretty cool, though. I like the little cars going around down there. That's a pretty effective and efficient visual effect. Those little belts of, like, motion or conveyor belts of cars. Yeah. You gotta respect somebody who just rolls up and throws hands against a dude with a laser sword. Oh boy. I gotta get out of the corner. That dude's gonna flip my ass. Work is now complete? Yeah! How are you guys adjusting? For those of you who are working from home, by the way. How are you adjusting? Because I know that, like, the end of the workday can be pretty ritualistic, you know? You, like, shut down your computer, you get up, you put on your jacket, you get in your car, you drive home. And I feel like that helps a lot of people sort of mentally transition from work mode to home mode. But I wonder, because I worked from home before, so it's kind of interesting to give your, like, be on the clock or be off the clock in the same place. Is there a better way to get to the Jedi Temple? Not with all these people trying to assassinate me. Just close your laptop and the same thing, yeah. I love rolling out of work and getting out into work and getting all my work done. Yeah. I've just did okay because my boss kind of uses an excuse to call me back to do something urgent at 9 p.m. Oh, that's... yeah. Maybe just stop answering the phone. I literally moved 6 feet from the kitchen table to the couch. It blows. Yeah, I feel like some people probably like that very explicit differentiation. I never really needed it, though, myself. I feel like I still feel... I mean, not that what I do these days is even is a work, honestly. But I always did like the feeling of just closing all my work tabs and being like, ah. Could they not have a longer sample? Who is this? Zaxby, who is this? Oh! I guess I was supposed to jump. Ow.
We've been waiting for you.
Jump on a ship. Bill. Yeah, yeah. It's Chameleon from Spider-Man. Oh! I remember that villain. I'm gonna assume for programmers it's easier. No dumbass open plan offices, no noisy coworkers. Just some routine morning chit-chat and coding for the rest of the day. I've never understood open workspaces for programmers. Like, I could see it for maybe artists or people that, like, need to collaborate or share ideas with things, but... if you're a coder, it seems like a lot of it is, yeah, you just... What the fuck was that? I tried to jump and it, like, there's, like, an invisible wall or something. Maybe I need to go another way. I'm probably playing this level again. That's okay. I can quit the game and start it over. Because cubicles depress people, it's a ruthless jail cell. Yeah, I guess. Cubicles are depressing if you're not allowed to customize your workspace at all. And that was kind of an issue in one of my jobs. Yeah. They let us put up some stuff, but there got to be regulations about shit you were allowed to put up, and it was just so dumb. But if I needed to do work, like, it was nice to just be able to shut the world out for a little bit and concentrate. And yeah, okay, they want me to go this way. Right. Bergazel, thanks for the prime sub. Oh. One thing that I do find interesting about Clone Wars that I'm sure will come to a head eventually is how any Jedi, whenever they beat any Sith, let them get away every time. Because, you know, they can't kill or whatever, something like that. I found it interesting and a little convenient how, in both episodes 9 and 6, the Jedi are allowed to defeat their enemies, destroy their enemies without actually killing them. It's like, there's only a very specific slice where, like, Luke can confront the Emperor and not have to murder him without defeating him. Oh yeah, I'm in HD and the game is so low res. No, that's just how it is. Yeah, unless you're Anakin, and then that's just a path to the dark side or whatever. So it's like... So it's like, as a Jedi, you legitimately have to just endlessly fight somebody until either they come around and turn good because of how tolerant you've been, or you have to hope that somebody else kills them for you. That's kind of it. Because, like, what would Luke have done if Vader didn't step up and toss the Emperor down a fucking ravine? I mean, I guess the Death Star was blowing up anyway, but still. I wonder about that. And somehow, also, this means that Vader was redeemed? Even though he killed the Emperor and a ton of people? Also, holy shit, the last time I watched Jedi, there's that line like, "Tell Leia, you were right." And I'm like, what a dick move! Imagine he goes back to Leia and he's like, "Leia, our dad, the guy who tortured you and also blew up your home planet and everything you know, murdered everyone, your parents, everybody, he was actually a pretty good guy. He told me, after I chopped his hand off, that he was sorry. And that he's actually a pretty good guy. So, I guess you can't be mad anymore, Leia. We good? We're good, alright." Yeah, then Leia would have had to kill Vader? Probably. She would have been good at it, too. She wouldn't have fucking hesitated, man. Jedi taking life as a last resort. It's not completely barred from them, except Anakin, who doesn't care. Okay. But what, like, what constitutes a last resort? I mean, it's an age-old moral imperative. If, like... If you can save a life by taking a life, is it justified? Or if you can save many lives by taking a life, is it justified? So... Oh yeah, Mace Windu fucking... He yeeted Jango Fett's head clean off, right in front of his kid, so... That's pretty sick. The light side of the Force and the Jedi Order are often on very different pages. Yeah, I'm kind of curious to see more of the Jedi Order being bullshit, because... It would be nice to empathize more with Anakin's frustration with the Jedi Order, and again... I'm virtually assured that is going to be spelled out in the old Clone Wars show. Jedi are allowed to kill. The point is that they are supposed to attempt to not do so. Killing shouldn't be common practice for the Jedi's. Sorry, I'm getting a little surrounded here. It's not about Anakin redeeming himself. It's about the hope Luke has for his father and the good that's still in him. I don't know. Yeah, no, I understand that, I think. I just think it's interesting that, like, given that there's all this hand-wringing going up to Luke confronting Vader, and Luke being like, "I can't kill him," and Yoda basically saying, like, "If you give in to your emotions, then that will start you on the path to the dark side, and there's really no turning back," which is odd, because then Anakin does actually turn back. And then the conversation that happens after that, after Yoda transcends or whatever, that ghost Obi-Wan comes back and he's basically like, "Hey, you're gonna have to kill your dad. They're not allowed to be attached." Yeah. It's the attachment that leads to fear and anger and hate. Which was... Oh! Great. Pretty... I mean, I thought it was pretty well borne out by Anakin. The way that he just could not stand to lose anything. Because he probably wasn't hugged enough as a kid. Man, really? I'm back at this checkpoint, huh?
We've been waiting for you.
I hate the train question of would you flip the switch? Oh, the trolley? Trolley moral dilemma? One of those choices is murder by choice. Neither choice will end well. And no, it's more about action versus inaction, and like, can you be empowered to? Sorry, I think the bigger thing that moral dilemma is supposed to bring up is like playing with the idea of somebody's agency in a moral dilemma. So it's like. There's more parts to the trolley problem than just the trolley problem, and that's usually where most people end, because that's largely, you know, it's just a weird boiling down of a moral dilemma. So, it starts with the switch. Would you flip a switch and kill one person to save five? And then it goes on to, would you shove someone onto the tracks? Like, does it feel different for you to pull a switch or to purposefully shove someone onto the tracks to make the train stop. It should. But why? You know? Just because you're physically touching them before they die? You're still taking an action. And at what point does it become uncomfortable for you? And in that mental process, that's when you can sort of try to suss out, okay, where does morality meet emotion? Ugh. I'm not certain that's Mundi's multiple wives are canon. Oh, always follow the Prime Directive. Always. Except in any episode where there's like a hot Irish babe to bang. If you take action, you are the murderer? Or are you? Should a self-driving car swerve to hit an elderly person to avoid a child? I mean, yeah, there are people who have to program that shit in. Or ignore the moral dilemma altogether. Everyone goes to that episode of TNG? I mean, I just think about it a lot, because that lady was pretty hot. Action is defined by consequence, according to Kant. So it is a good action if the outcome is superior. While I understand the point, I always had a problem with it because my borderline Aspie self was like, a fat person can't stop a train, you're just murdering six people. I think the idea is that... I agree, because I had similar concerns of like, well... Because then it gets into problems of determinism. Like, how can you be sure that shoving somebody onto the track is going to save any lives? Obviously, it's just a moral exercise, so you have to kind of take the... you have to take it at face value. I just got juggled, man. These guys are brutal. Growing up on the main streets of Coruscant. I always took it to mean, like, there's a train conductor who doesn't know that five people are on the track ahead. So if one person falls on the track ahead of that, then the train conductor will stop the train. But then you could just say, well, why not shove anything else onto the tracks? And yes, there's a million ways to think around the problem, but that's kind of not... theoretically not the point. It's to dwell on the moral dilemma of it. Oh, action is defined by intention? Oh, okay. I don't know that I agree with that, though. Because people can do bad things with good intentions. Or even hide behind good intentions. And I think you're still responsible for the outcome regardless. That's something that I had to learn growing up. I had a lot of friends where I kind of refused to take responsibility for the times that my actions would have unintended consequences. Holy shit! And kind of like, there were times where I would do shitty things to my friends and refuse to apologize for it, because in my mind, if I didn't mean to hurt them, then the hurt that they felt was incidental and that they should just kind of get over it, because like, people get hurt accidentally all the time. I have since come to understand or come to embrace that is not the best way to think about people's emotions, especially I think it's an inversion of how to think about action and consequences. Like, you may have intended something good, but if something bad happened, if you can do an action then that can make things better, you should. To a point, because there are people who will also manipulate that. They will constantly make you feel like you have to perform for them or do things for them. So, you know, there's limits to it. That was one thing I always thought was odd about, like, Christianity, even. I remember hearing a lot like, oh, you should like open your home and give to the needy and stuff like that. Turn the other cheek. And I was like, that doesn't quite add up. You gotta stick up for yourself at some point, otherwise you're gonna spend your entire life being a doormat, and like, Christian dogma would say yes, you're supposed to, because the real life you're going to have is in heaven with God, so just let people walk all over you on planet Earth. And in every like Christian movie, that would happen, and then the bad guys would be like, wow, I guess Jesus really is great. And they would like stop bullying the dude because of his divine Christianity. And then I tried doing that a couple of times in real life, and I just got stepped on. So, yeah, they don't care. People don't care. They'll take what they can take. So I don't know, man. It's tough. There was a time where I promised myself that it would be possible to have like some kind of ironclad moral code that would be rigidly applicable in all circumstances, and I've since backed way off of that concept. Now thinking that you can have a loose set of guidelines, but most circumstances are going to be custom and require their own judgment. Christ did use the Force. How do you think he floated on water? He resurrected. Everything Christ did. Well, I guess there really has been no example of somebody using the Force to summon a burger. Christ used a stand? That's a good point, yeah. Well, yeah, I guess that's true. Can't argue with that. So I won't. Yeah, what was Jesus' midichlorian count? So, people got healed of leprosy just by touching Jesus' tunic. Imagine what could happen if you got a little vial of Jesus' ejaculate. Your eyes would glow. You'd probably be able to fly for like at least a week. Think of the latest Rick and Morty. Yeah, people have brought that up, connected with some of the things I've been talking about, but I haven't seen it yet. Was Jesus Darth Plagueis? I think Jesus would have been, or Darth Plagueis would have been. That's a good question. See? Good questions. This is the world's number one premier think tank. That was awesome. Oh, there he goes. They want a one guy. Ow. Ow. Shit. Alright, well that's it. Game over. Why did I do that? Well, whatever, who cares? Yeah, big F for Plo. That's it. Okay, so I'm gonna quit the game just for safety's sake here. Which wise men were you in the school play? I don't think I was ever cast in a nativity. Yeah, J. Rickle, all the lightsaber colors are all fucked up. How does it not have the fucking? I guess that's the BIOS, not the logo. It needs to have the boom boom. Pissed off. I'm pissed off and I'm mad. And I'm pissed off. And it's crackly again. Just gotta reset the encoder for some reason. Oh god, it's warm in here. Oh, I need to eat my words a little bit. I do recall saying that LucasArts was basically a done studio, but I think LucasArts is still active on The Old Republic. A reference. I don't think anything's internally developed at LucasArts, but it is still a brand. Using an Xbox to capture your PlayStation for stream? No, I'm using a, Elgato. There is a particular external Elgato. No, it's not an Xbox. What are you guys talking about? This is not an Xbox. This is PlayStation 3. What about that looked like an Xbox? The side panels are just from Elgato Capture software. So I have a PS3 running into a Elgato external. But it's one of the ones that has like a lag-free preview. So I'm using the preview window on my computer to play the game, which my computer is then outputting to another capture card. So, yeah, you heard it here first. You can plug your PS3 directly into an Xbox. Was there anything cool with the Xbox stuff today? There was. Maybe a lot less than people were expecting, because it was like a third-party kind of AA showcase. But I thought there was a lot of good stuff. Blooper Team's next game looks awesome. Huge Silent Hill vibes, and not just because it has Akira Yamaoka as the composer, although, like, the second that demo came up, and actually, Nah, I shouldn't. The second that demo came up, and like, it was that sort of imagery of there being the real world and then like a nightmare world that only one person can see. I was like, oh shit, this is fucking, this is Silent Hill. And then the Akira Yamaoka music kicked in, and I was like, ah! And, but it's like, it's a Bloober Team game, which is, you know, I'm still cool with. Was it The Medium? Or something like that. What game is this? Jedi Power Battles, PlayStation 1 game. Yeah, the Vampire the Masquerade trailer was a little funky. I was like, ooh boy, those character models don't look very good. But then, like, I saw the World of Darkness logo at the beginning, and I was like, is this Mage or something like that? Are we getting an... And then after a while, when I saw the Vampire Chomps, I was like, oh, it's Vampire the Masquerade. Okay. I give it a buy then. Like, it doesn't have to look photorealistic, because that's not really what it's about. Jesus had an unconfirmed midichlorian count, but based upon his showings in canon, I assume he had the equivalent force sensitivity of Corrin Horn, who has little telekinetic power, but plenty of other powers. His count is 10,700 per cell. Multiply that by the average load of a human male. Jesus comes at least 480 million midichlorians. Yeah. They biffed it a little bit by touting gameplay when there was none. I don't know what that's all about. No! God damn it. Well, I just fucking died, so... I mean, I didn't even get to a checkpoint, so I might as well get my life back. Did you ever play Rebel Assault? I did not, no. Think Sony will reveal stuff soon? I don't know. Technically, they already did. Sony's press rollout has been very, very weird. I don't know why. They seem bizarrely attached to, like, legacy outlets and older ways of announcing things. Like, why they would give the exclusive reveal to, like, what was it, Wired? Makes no sense to me. But whatever. It was gameplay through a cinematic camera. Yeah, that's not gameplay, though. There is something called gameplay, and it's not that. Yeah, Rebel Assault has FMVs. Is Rebel Assault on, like, good old games or anything like that? So yeah, despite... I mean, they were pretty clear that it was going to be a third-party showcase, and it very much delivered on that, I thought. I thought what nobody really seems to talk about is the like, breadth and variety of what was shown. I think they made a pretty strong showing for third-party support on the Series X. That's obviously not what people wanted to see. Because in terms of normal marketing beats, that usually comes to, like, second or third. You show off your big known properties, your first-party stuff first. And you do it in, like, a very sort of live demo way that's supposed to show off every part of your new ecosystem. So I'm sure people... I wanted to see Halo, I wanted to see Gears, I wanted to see Forza. Or whatever. Like, more sinuous sacrifice. Scorn looked good, yeah. I don't know what kind of game Scorn's gonna be. I'm gonna guess it's gonna be like a Bloober Team style horror walking simulator. Dirt, I was excited to see. I love that series. Was that anime beat 'em up? No, there was nothing on Elden Ring. That Bandai Namco game. Scarlet something? Fortnite 2, Fortnite-er. Oh yeah, the Yakuza game was a pretty cool look. I was like, is this Yakuza? This looks like Yakuza. And when that dude had, like, the wide 70s lapels, I was like, yep, okay, this is Yakuza. Sick. Oh yeah, the enemies in Scarlet Nexus looked really cool. But, like, demon fire, or demon flower bouquets. That's kind of neat. So yeah, Homerton, I was thinking about that too. I was like, I thought I've seen this game before. It kind of reminded me of the reveal trailer for Soma. How it was, like, very body horror Geiger-esque, which was clearly all over the Scorn trailer. But aside from that, it was like, it did kind of remind me a little bit of like Agony, just in terms of being like kind of gameplay light, atmospheric heavy, walking horror walking simulator kind of thing. Scorn made me uncomfortable. It was supposed to. Oh, is there a dripping penis? Oh, the wobbly horse cock from the wall? Yeah. That was fun. Maybe I should do a thing where I just watch through all the trailers and kind of talk over them. I thought about streaming it this morning, but I was like, eh. I don't need to do everything. This is not Jedi Knight anymore? No. Jedi Knight's been defeated. Been conquered. Well, that reminds me, I gotta add it to my Gamer Conquest list, which I haven't been doing a good job of maintaining. Yeah, no, I saw Bruce did it. That's another reason I was like, ah, Bruce is already doing it. If you do everything, they're gonna take your Twitch mansion? I mean, you're right, Jay Rickle. Every minute you're not on Twitch is a minute you could be on Twitch. Getting more subs, getting more bits. Yeah, Namastrot, that the dude didn't say world premiere. I had to say it every time. I was pissed off. I've been missing a lot of subs, I'm sorry. Bergazelle, thank you for the Prime sub. Superduck, 1212, thank you. Cozy Art, thank you for the resub. And XSP, wait. Bedhands, thank you for the Prime sub. I like that Xbox is pacing out these game reveals and console news instead of blowing the load in 1 week at E3. Yeah, I think that's what's going to take people to sort of get over. Is I think people are still in the mode of expecting a giant brick of reveals. And yeah, I mean, this is better for Xbox. They get more bites with the news cycle. I feel like. No one ever considers this, nor should they, really, because most people are, you know, consumers, and they think about it from that angle, but consider that Microsoft put all the third-party partners first. Like, they gave the biggest, like, maybe not the biggest, because we haven't seen the biggest yet, but they gave the first look to all of their publishing partners, which is a huge deal in terms of, like, inter-corporate relationships. I think that says a lot about like Microsoft's attempts to make the Xbox a robust third-party platform as well as first-party. It also could just be that their first-party games weren't ready to be seen yet. Like maybe Halo Infinite's just not ready, and they maybe this was just a last-ditch effort to reshuffle the deck and have something ready for a... For like a... They had to hit timing or something like that. But I thought, like... I don't know that necessarily it's received this way, but if the goal was to say, like, look, you're gonna have plenty to play on Series X in the launch window, that's the message I got. I was a little disappointed because it, you know, obviously wasn't the big stuff I wanted to see. Nothing was just like outright a technical marvel, which is kind of what people are hoping for, is something that like blows you away, that you see definitively could not be possible on last gen, and I don't even know that we're going to see that for a while. Yeah, there wasn't a lot of gameplay either. Yeah, I don't know. It's Infinite. My gut says that Infinite probably should have come out like 2 years ago. I think Xbox's problem is marketing this as a gameplay showcase. Yeah. Yeah, that was not a smart call. I don't know why that was done. I mean, they got people to watch, but certainly was not a gameplay showcase. It was an announcement showcase, which is fine. That's fun too. But yeah. I agree. I was very confused. I mean, and like Assassin's Creed Odyssey, even Ubisoft was like, here comes gameplay, and then it didn't. Harlan, thank you for the resub. I'll watch Jeff Keighley's thing. Oh, bonus round? That's the other weird thing. It's like Summer Game Fest. He's putting every gaming announcement thing under the, like, Game Fest banner, but it's not his. He tried to wrap his branding around the Xbox thing, and it wasn't his production. He's just trying to associate himself with everything everyone else is doing to make it sound like he's running the show, but he's very much not. I thought that was a little weird. Well, I guess it's the same as, like, any other outlet, right? They restream it and then talk about it. But I'm like, wait a minute, why did you go to all this effort to, like, brand and announce this big thing to make it sound like you're replacing E3? You're not doing that! You just made a website to, like, say everything else. I thought that was weird. He's great at branding. Yeah, I guess so. And I can't fault him. Like, it's smart. I guess. It's just a little weird. Cause, like, he put out this whole calendar of, like, boy, Summer Game Fest going crazy. And he listed all these things that I know he has nothing to do with. Well, that was odd. Ow. Will E3 be a thing after this? Yeah. E3 is still important. I don't know. There's so many angles beyond the I'm mad at E3 and I want it to go away from the consumer perspective. I mean, I personally have beef with the ESA because they leaked personal info for people that I work with, my friends. So I'm not too pleased with the ESA. I also think they've been exceedingly disturbingly cowardly when it comes to attacking gambling-like features in video games. Should do fun painting for your charity again? If you want. I'm not gonna lie, man. Organizing that was kind of a pain in the ass last time. Not because of you. It was more there were people who were supposed to help and didn't help. And then lost shit. It was just really aggravating to deal with. Now that I'm on my own, it's been much easier. I don't have to, like, run everything through somebody else and then have people try and bite off angles about how it can be more personally beneficial. Bang. Dang it, that also halved my health. Organization politics a little bit. More just like people that say they're gonna do things and then don't do them. And then since I'm the point of contact for certain things, it like becomes my fault. And it becomes more work for me. That's the thing. That's the thing that I think is just really frustrating. When somebody says when you ask for help and then you try to delegate tasks, which is in itself work, and then the people who accept tasks as part of that delegation, then fuck up those tasks. So not only did you spend time trying to delegate, but now you also have to spend time untangling a mess that somebody else made of something that should have been super easy. I'm getting in the weeds on things that don't matter, but I agree. I enjoy philanthropy myself. I gotta be really careful because I'm really, really low on life. I can't resist those delicious pickups. Those are Cocoa's eyes? They might be. They weren't intended to be. I use those eyes because I think they were one of the top image search results when I just put an anime into Google, so hopefully it doesn't break the mystery for you. The magic. Fuck. Ugh. More of a misanthrope myself. I would be. I gotta buy my way to heaven. Fuck! I think I'm just dead, yeah. That shot took me down. The checkpoints in this stage are kind of really cruel. Holy crap, this is so far back. Feels like an Easter egg? Okay, then don't let me talk you out of it. I mean, odds are that's how the editor made, I think it was John, made Kokopa? Probably just Googled anime eyes and used the same thing that I did. Yeah, anime eyes PNG, they're the first result. Yup. I can guarantee you that's how Kokopo was made. Oh, the medium will launch on Game Pass? Yeah, that is very cool. It's weird to articulate that, like, And this is something that Microsoft has tried to convey, but maybe hasn't done so successfully. But like, I feel like day one on Series X is going to be way more interesting than day one on PS5. Because you're going to have Game Pass, and then you're going to have games that are automatically upgraded. I guess PS5 is going to have that too with its digital library. But I feel like through Game Pass, Microsoft, if you have a Game Pass subscription, you're going to have so much to dig through. Even from the perspective of like, I got a shiny new console, let's try out this older game, see what it looks like in 4K. I feel like it's going to be... and backwards compatibility. Still really don't know what the story is from PlayStation, so it's possible that, like, that first evening glee might still be there for PS5, but... I just remember, like, day one PS4 and Xbox One. Like, PS4 was pretty good, because there was, like, Killzone Shadowfall, which is kind of neat. And that was pretty much it. What did Xbox One launch with? Man, it was bad. Sony's been weirdly quiet. Yeah, I don't know. Sony's marketing has always been a little weird. They tend to be very austere, and they just kind of do one thing, and that's it. Oh, Rise? What was like Chorus? It even has a similar subtitle. I was like, okay, there's our Rise. Sunset Overdrive. Yeah, and Killer Instinct. Yeah, you're right. Okay. Yeah, Rise was okay. Oh yeah, and Sony had The Order. Those were kind of the two pretty but stupid games that did launch. I hope we'll get another wave of those with the next gen of just like, this game's really pretty, but boy is it dumb. Yeah, Corvus. I was into that though. It's been a while since there's been a space plane fly around, blow stuff up game. I like those. Oh yeah, Dead Rising 3. Man. Ugh. Dead Rising 3. Damn it. Thought he was gonna flip me. Waiting for the next freelancer? That's elite dangerous, my dude. Elite Dangerous doesn't have the depth of Freelancer? What? That is the opposite of anything I've ever heard. What kind of depth did Elite not have that Freelancer did? Crimson Dragon, yeah, D4. Interesting lineup. I'm remembering now. There's been a number of times that Microsoft has tried to, like, shit! Ooh. Has tried to win cred with the gamers by, like, pulling out a really obscure Japanese franchise to reboot or invest in, and no one ever cares. Microsoft is like, remember Panzer Dragoon? Remember? Everyone was like, nope. PS4, PS4. Oh, I love it. They want so hard to be liked. They're like the fat kid in class. They're just trying to be extra nice to everybody. They pick stuff that's too obscure. Yeah, Phantasy Star Online. Yeah, we got it, guys. Phantasy Star Online 2. What? Somebody's asleep. What? What did you say? Were you talking about a video game? That was a very good idea. Oh, Star Citizen is like Freelancer? Yeah, I guess I can see that. Oh, you're gonna be working at Cloud Imperium? Ooh, okay. Harlan, we'll have to be a little reserved then. No, I'm not. I have no bad blood towards Star Citizen. I genuinely hope that everything's going okay. Welcome back, Nitro. Pocky and Rocky. You guys remember Bubsy? Boo! Yeah, you do. Well, we're bringing him back. Everyone's favorite cat. He's rude, he's crude, he's got attitude. Bubsy 3D 2. Bubsy 4D. Series X exclusive smell-o-vision. Your entire apartment will smell like cat litter while you play Bubsy 4D. Spy Kids had smell-o-vision? Was it just like scratch and sniff cards for parts of it? Okay, so the red credit symbol or whatever that is does actually... I can't remember what symbol that is. Fuck, I gotta beeline for the checkpoint just in case. There we go. You know you're safe when Yoda's chuckling at you. The studio that created Bubsy 3D also did Days Gone. Man, but that had to be like 15 years removed, right? Oh, they showed Beyond Good and Evil too early. I mean, that's a verifiable fact at this point, given that the game isn't out. When did they show that? Like 2013? Damn right, Plo Koon. Jay Fly High. Playing the sickest Star Wars video game of all. This jump's so weird, because it seems like there's like an invisible wall sometimes. For me, I was so intrigued by the idea of multiple player crewed ships. No, I don't have any friends that would play with me. Aw. You mean for a Star Citizen? You can kinda get that. That vibe does exist in Sea of Thieves a little bit. It shouldn't be on Good and Evil 2 before The Witcher, now Cyberpunk will come out ahead of it. Oh. Well, wait, what? Because I remember they showed that first trailer for Cyberpunk back in 2013, I'm pretty sure. Beyond Good and Evil was announced in 2016, okay. Huh, okay. I thought it was longer ago than that, but... Don't have to be right, I just have to say things. That's true. You say it mad enough, you have to be right. Oh, I'm out of force. God damn it. I mean, that was pretty cool, actually, but... Man. Oh, come on! Fuck me, why did I... I should have just left him. Ugh. God! I don't think I ever made it past this checkpoint, actually, because this checkpoint is so long. Felt it was Plo Doom. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Getting harassed by Star Wars Voldemort. Who is this guy? Zach? Oh no, you can't keep saying chameleon from the Star Wars cartoon. Oh, you didn't say that, but still. That's his evil twin Plo Koom. He gets to ejaculate as much as he wants, while Plo has to store it all up. This music keeps turning into Omicron, and I'm not a fan. You're not a fan of art? I thought we respected art in this chat. Oh man, Xbox All-Stars? That'd be sick. I mean, PlayStation certainly tried that. That was kind of cringy. I don't know, as much as Sony's first-party games are amazing, in a roster, their lineup just seems so creatively scattershot, so trying to cram them all into a game made almost no sense. Yeah, I guess you're right. Killer Instinct has kind of become Xbox All-Stars. Never thought about it that way. They got a Battletoad, they got an Arbiter. Now they just need a Forza car. Jesus. Blinks the Time Sweeper. Okay. I forget Rom. Oh, he's in there? Oh, I forgot, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Man, they got a Gears character in there? Sea of Thieves boat. What game is this? Jedi Power Battles. Motherfuck! No! God! How did that bolt chase me that whole way? Oh, the one you were talking about? Killer Instinct? Drastic? Are you raising a 7-year-old kitten? Or a 3-week-old kitten? I'm sorry. I just saw the Drastic 7. Sorry. Hopefully my gamer moment didn't aggravate your kitten. Palcom, thanks for the cheer. Christ. Did like what Ashraf Ismail said about Assassin's Creed Valhalla? More brutal combat, they've reworked RPG mechanics to get rid of enemy levels. Okay. I mean, Ubisoft first party stuff is usually real solid effort. Even if sometimes their series can get a little derivative after a while. But, I mean, whatever. Thing is, like, Assassin's Creed usually runs on really amazing tech, so it's actually really exciting to see what that game's gonna look and run like. Their engines are usually astoundingly amazing, and I don't know that they necessarily get credit for being, like, as tech-forward as they usually are. So I'm excited to see it from that perspective. There is a healthy amount of input lag that is not from the capture hardware. I think it's just the game engine. AC combat is frustrating? You think so? It's just dirt easy for me. Like, I feel like, so I don't know. I'm just playing Origins a bit, and it's like it comes in two flavors. It's either pathetically easy or so overleveled that you can't reasonably be expected to win. Like, you just don't do enough damage and they'll one-shot you and that's it. Doesn't feel like there's a lot of middle ground where, like, your skill matters that much. Either you're level appropriate, which means you're gonna win just by mashing buttons, or you're so underleveled that it's, like, statistically nearly impossible. I am curious where the story's gonna go, though. Because the story starts, and I've kind of already finished the revenge mission of Origins setup. Origins has a way better story than Odyssey? Oh, that's a bummer. I was kind of hoping the story stuff would get better. That's okay. Okay. Ugh. Oh, there's so many!
Yamakiya!
How there's not a checkpoint here is beyond me. Sorry, there's nothing for me. If they just did a fully historical era game, I'd be happy. Well, there's like the exploration mode in Origins. It's kind of neat. They were bringing back Desmond Miles. They refer to him, but no, he's dead. Sorry, spoilers. I mean, even their Splinter Cell games were kind of all over the map, tonally. They went from, like, being pretty hardcore stealth games in the early days to turning into sort of, like, Jason Bourne action games. Don't get me wrong, Mark and Execute, really cool game feature, but, man, you can... The later Splinter Cell games, they were just pretty much straight-up action games.
Yamakiya!
Early Splinter Cell was amazing, yeah. The correct video game opinion that I share is that Chaos Theory is still just, man, can't touch it. I mean, I still listen to the soundtrack from Chaos Theory now and again, because I just like a Montobin. Any health down those pathways? Those are not pathways you can go down. The camera does not allow you to. I'm doing okay on health. There, jeez. Okay, I'm not gonna pick that red thing up. Deflecting bolts at these guys is way easier than having them uncork their Terras Kasi on me. There we go. Yeah, this is Coruscant, theoretically. That dude saw me coming. He edgeguarded me. This is the real Smash Brothers. Fuck, I'm gonna go for it. There we go. He wanted to kill me that badly. God. God, frame rate's tanking here. Too many polygons. I don't care.
Melko, don't juba. Melko, don't juba.
Shut up and shoot your gun. There we go. Oh yeah. Important to mention that Rahul is still running his donation campaign for direct relief. So if you, like Jay just did, if you use the command SAND, you will get a link to that campaign page. And if they get to $30,000, they'll try to recite episode 2 from memory. That's important. That's important. Oh boy. Oh, and he's gone. Love it. I want to activate this gun, man. There we go. Okay. Hold. Oh, it knocked him back, so we unactivated again. All right. Hold. There we go. I'm getting a little runway here, so if he uppercuts me, I won't fly off the stage. Or maybe, like, line it up like this. Nice. Games you're most excited about this year? I mean, yeah, Cyberpunk. I guess Valhalla. Valhalla looks cool. I gotta do my homework first, though. Gotta beat Origins and, Odyssey. Apart from that, I think I'd have to look at a release calendar to remember what's like officially this year. Whoa! I do always like new console time because it is fun to see developers kind of just single-mindedly explore. Holy shit! Explore the possibility space of new hardware. I don't mind big, dumb, pretty games. I don't mind, like, technical showcases. Oh, what was it? It was, like, The Ascent? That one game that I swore to God was Ruiner 2 before they showed the title. Because it even had, like, the red texts, like, big text hits over quote-unquote gameplay. Like, isometric view. There's a ring around your character. Yeah. The Vampire the Masquerade trailer was a little weird. Agreed. Okay. You can teleport, why not? Yeah, Ghost of Tsushima will be fun. I don't know. The gameplay I've seen, it kind of looks like a pretty by-the-numbers sort of... I mean, by-the-numbers is a weird thing to say because they just don't really make that kind of game anymore, but... I think it might be really boring. I think that game might be boring as hell. We'll see. I mean, I'm down just for the tour, like the digital tourism aspect, but oh come on, really? This is like a log area. Yeah, I'm optimistic too, but I watched the gameplay and I didn't see anything that was like, oh wow, that's an interesting mechanic. It was mostly just really slow-paced cinematic, like horse trotting, getting off, sword fights that seemed pretty mechanically basic. Okay. I'm willing to be wrong about that. I also didn't study it super closely, so just kind of one casual watch through, and I was like, okay, there's parry, there's like a loose combo system. Didn't look anything nearly as like in depth as like Sekiro, which is gonna obviously be the point of comparison everyone's gonna make. So I gotta get ready for that. Yeah, thanks, camera. Camera is now my best friend. Did I pick up the credit already? Maybe I didn't. Oh, Deadly Premonition 2. Yeah, that's gonna be fun. It'll be fun to play through Premonition 1 again. That game doesn't really take very long, right? If you long sword. If you don't just spend tons of hours bopping around the open world, I remember Deadly Premonition 1 moving pretty quickly, like 20 hours maybe. Crashes like fuck. I played it on Xbox 360 and I didn't really get any crashes, but maybe it's I would imagine it's probably worse on PC. That'll be fun. Some artisanal coffee and Deadly Premonition streams. That sounds good. Gonna hop over to Bruce's channel for a bit? No worries, man. Everyone should watch Sweet Bruce. What's he playing this today? You need the Infinite Magnum to deal with some of the hard enemies? In Deadly Premonition? I played through it on Xbox 360 on hard, and I don't remember it being that big of an issue. Always Minecraft, okay. I just want to let you guys know, because people were asking about it. I did try to install RTX Voice on my streaming PC, because I read some benchmarks, and it actually doesn't really take up that much GPU. However, following the guide to get it to install, it totally didn't install, and in fact, it's kind of frozen my computer now. So the installer won't run. It just won't, and when I try to delete the temporary files, it won't let me. So, I now have... I have something on my computer now that will never go away, I guess. God damn it, there's a droid, there's a probe right there. Oh, it's messing with people's audio, really? Fuck! I did restore. Try turning off the monitor, nice. I think it created a restore point after I installed it, and then I don't have another restore point. I should have made one. But, try turning off the monitor. So it's really not a big deal. I mean, everything still seems functional. I mean, I'm streaming right now, so we're good. But, what program was this? RTX Voice. Why are they doing this, man? It's like they know and they're intentionally using it as game design, which is the worst. Now that we're getting on into the summer months, shit! Stop it! Every fucking jump! There's a new ball that just knocks you out of the air, pieces of shit. God. This is just straight up trolling now. Fucking hell. Okay. Anyway, summer months. There's probably just gonna be more fans and AC units and shit. On in this room, and I was like, oh, it'd be nice to cover up, remove all that with some power of AI. Maybe like ray tracing will eventually open it up for other video cards. Explicitly for other video cards, but. Excuse me. But yeah, I tried following the directions to get it to install, and I did the modification, I ran the installer again, it went straight to installation not complete, or aborted or whatever. I guess this is just another part of the stage. Probably a boss fight. And yeah, now it won't install and it's stuck. Overcome the mercenaries who wish to stop you from reaching the Temple of the Jedi. Oh, it's still, yeah, same level, alright. Is this the Temple of the Jedi, or am I still on rooftops? I took an elevator down to another rooftop, alright. What if you still had to do jumps with little laser orbs that shot you out of the goddamn sky? Okay, well, at least there wasn't one there. It gets worse? Great. Fucking great. Well, don't worry, I'm gonna beat it. Pro gamer. Yeah, RTX Voice is like an alpha release. Yeah, but it's really encouraging. Some of the results that I've seen makes me feel like I can probably like turn on some big ass fans in this room and it might be okay. Cause it's I'm not gonna lie, a little toasty right now. I've read the prequel novelizations. No. Yeah, this is the real 1313. See, it's not so bad that they canceled it. What is RTX Voice meant to do? It is a noise removal, AI-driven noise removal algorithm, so it's apparently extremely powerful. There's a dude who had like a leaf blower next to his microphone, and when he turned on RTX Voice, it just zeroed it out entirely. And his voice was still extremely clear. It's a bummer because I would like for it to be more functional. We could use it on the podcast, which would be nice. Bruce and I are in pretty noisy rooms. And I do my best to basically I'll do noise removal. Kraken's audio is frustratingly amazing. I don't know what he does. I gotta ask him about that. I think he just has a quiet room, but yeah, I'll do noise removal on both of our audio tracks, and then EQ to try to bring some of the warmth back, because noise removal can kind of make you sound tinny. Bruce especially, man, he's in a very windy room. What podcast is this? Oh, they Talk to the Internet podcast. We do it once a week. Bruce, Kraken, and I will just kind of talk about whatever. It's fun. But I was just, oh, that reminds me. I just finished the edit on that. I forgot I have to upload that to Drive. Don't look at this. Don't. Okay. This is a PlayStation. It actually is a PlayStation. It's just, I have a very peculiar setup, but it works for me. Works perfectly for me. It just took a while to get here. Okay. I gotta upload this to Drive so I can send it to my homies. Hold on. There we go. Kraken is good people. Oh. Kraken seems like one of those dudes that I kind of wish was my friend. For a long time. I feel like if he were my friend while I was 20, he probably wouldn't have wanted to be my friend when I was like 20, but I feel like he would have taught me a lot about what it is to be like a decent, well-adjusted person. Just accidentally, by being a chill and very rad dude. I'd disappoint Kraken if he were my friend. I get that vibe. I find it wonderfully refreshing that when we dip into toilet humor, he's like, I'm not into this. There's no reason for this. I'm like, I kind of agree. It's just a weird wavelength to get on. All right, see you later, asshole. Nice. Man, that bicycle kick is intense. Tereskasi and nothing to sneeze at, clearly. I do love that thunk of people hitting the ground. Oh. God, I was like, I have to pick it up but not run too fast because I'll just careen off the edge. Yeah. I'm gonna say this out right now, just to make sure we're all on the same page. Normally I'm not for people spamming chat with all caps, but Caps Lock Hype is allowed to. Because it's the core of Caps Lock Hype's being. Also, when the name discloses that it's done out of hype and not out of anger, it's much easier to deal with. This is a very long level. I was worried that there might be levels so long that I can't possibly get through it without tripping into whatever dumbass, like, memory leak thing this game has going on. Oh, shit. Longest level in the game? Okay. What? Fuck you! Whoa! Oh my god. If that didn't happen earlier in the level, there's no way. I would have thought to okay, whew. Thought the music cut out. Which is the sign, one of the four horsemen. High as fuck, just realized we've been here for an hour and a half. Yeah. It's been a minute. Ah, oh, checkpoint. Okay. Great, another thing where perspective is impossible to see. Yep! What the fuck? Ugh, okay. Okay. Good lord, this level doesn't stop. Hey, Belongadong. Haven't been able to watch much since having to move back home. Making my way through 7 VODs. Oh, hold on a second. Just wanted to drop by and leave a sub so I don't miss those sweet, sweet news larders. Alright. Good luck with the move. Sounds like an exciting time. Snootzor. Thank you for subbing with the simple message, Newt Gunray. Indeed, indeed. We all remember Newt. Betrayed by Palpatine. Was there a book that focused on Newt Gunray, like showed him going home to his wife and kids, trying to just put food on the table for them? Hey Yuckus, thanks for the Prime sub. Wait, which way am I supposed to go? Wait, what? damn. I was hoping there'd be... I was hoping at some point they would try to, like, humanize Newt. Provide a tragic backstory for him. Also, but I have a job again? Yeah, don't... If times are remotely tight, don't give me your money, please. Again, like I said, if you get homeless because you're paying for subs, you don't get to sleep... You don't get to sleep in my Twitch mansion. Yeah, I'm sorry to hear that, Gru. If you're having a... Dude, if you're having a really hard time, if I can take some of the pressure off, let me know. Seriously, just whisper or DM me or something. This dude's pushing me towards the wall. Which way do you want me to go, game? Oh, okay. Okay, cool. I picked the right way. Eddie Vane, thanks for the resub. Also, let's see. Did you give you a free month of my only snap? God, no. Are you kidding me? You met. That's worth 20 grand a month at least. There's no way in hell I'm giving that away. Jeez. Give my snap for a month. Are you kidding me? I mean, you must be kidding me because that's a joke. I've seen this game. Looks great. I'm having a good time with it. It is pretty fucking trolly though. This game has been mean, and I feel like every time you have to do a blind jump, I feel like it's time for the game to be mean again. Eddie Vane, thanks for gifting some subs. Carefully stalking forward. This bridge looks like it's gonna fall. Ow. Okay. Got the news yesterday, at least in Germany. We can stay employed with only a fraction of the pay. At least it's guaranteed that I will be employed again when the shit is over. Just got a Prime sub, so hang in there. I feel so bad. It's getting rough, man. I feel like everybody was okay with it for a couple months, but especially in America, now that there's not really the guarantee of any kind of, like, assistance programs, I understand why people are starting to lose their minds a little bit, and demanding that things open up again. Yeah, you're damn right, Plo Koon. I'm excited to get to know this character. Seems pretty chill in Clone Wars so far. Yeah, a lot of us are still waiting on stimulus. And I'm sure our dear sweet government, our bootstraps government, will do everything they can to make sure you don't get it. We'll see. Oh, Christ. Well, that was that sucked. I almost sneezed. Caps lock hype. Yeah, I'm finally watching Clone Wars. It's okay, guys. Tough question here. Is Clone Wars an anime? Oh no. Shit. Oh fuck. He broke my guard. Alright, I'm just gonna go. It's not. Okay, I was hoping it would count. Checkpoint? Okay. Yamachiya! No, fuck y'all. How about fuck y'all? The car's back? The party car? There's no gap in the track this time. Oh crap. How is he big? Whatever. Dad had a new job in the bag and COVID showed up and that ruined it. My brother lost his job since it was a boba tea place in a mall. For existing right now, my mom's income and funds from the GI Bill. Shit. It shouldn't be like that. It shouldn't be like that. Why did I blow up immediately? Oh, he throws grenades. All right. What if I activated glow power? We weren't expecting glow power, were ya? I guess that just makes me invincible for a while. It's actually pretty handy. Oh. This dude can just straight up fucking teleport, huh? I'm gonna need to know if this shit is canon. Oh. Get him, boys! Oh, he's back. Jedi, what if I kick him? What if I kicked him in the face? Jedi are weak to kicks. And the music stopped. Oh god, I'm worried. And the like car sound effect is still going. I think it froze. Yep. That level is so long. I can't beat it. Without the fucking memory leak kicking in. Or whatever that is. Yeah, speedrun time. I guess I just have to keep playing it. I was worried, because like, when I heard that car sound not shutting off, even when I paused it, I was scared. Fuck, man. I'll try it again now that I'm more familiar with the level, but yeah, it's gotta be, I guess, cheat codes to checkpoint skip. Maybe? Maybe? Yeah, it's the Xbox. It's the Xbox emulator. This is broken enough, you should just skip it. Also the sound- oh, never mind, it's back. Also, I think it's crackly again. I'll try it one more time. Save states. Yeah, luckily the Xbox emulator I'm using has save states. Oh man. It's only a 90-minute level. I mean, some of those checkpoints are really far apart. So if I can get the like one in the middle of the stage, I feel like if I biff that checkpoint like twice, then I'll run out of time. So I just gotta move quick. Maybe just don't stop and fight anything. Maybe this is I just gotta speed run it. Oh, fuck me. Okay, so I'll try to just sprint through it and not shoot anything. We'll see how this goes. Yeah, checkpoints are weirdly and terribly distributed. I guess I can pick up power-ups, but there's really no point in that either. Wow, look at you! Mm-hmm. The orbs are still chasing me. God, that sound. Oh, wait. I wasn't supposed to go this way, that's right. Oh! Alright, and we're off. That's right. Over here. Sure. I did not die at the boss. No. I did not die. The boss died. And yet here I am, playing this stage again. Isn't that weird? That's weird, isn't it? I think that's weird. That was sick! Oh! Shit. Okay. It's okay. Everything's fine. These guys really hate Jedi. Like, really hate them. Oh, Techno Yumise? Goodbye. Thanks for watching. Possible to double jump? How can I learn this power? Okay, here we go. Nope! Oh wait, this isn't the really bad part. Fucking sound. Okay, this is the longest shittiest checkpoint here. Takanda C. Thank you for the Prime sub. It's like fighting Artorias. It's kind of like doing a boss run. Except it's a, oh, you have to kill these dudes for some reason. Faster than me! Oh, fucking Christ. Oh! Ooh, ooh. Hurt. It's this way. Shit! Fuck! There's a checkpoint right there! God damn it. I made it. Whatever. I'm going so much faster. Turns out not playing the game is how you have to play the game. This should work out. Yeah, I think this will be fine. And Memory Lake is catching it. Yeah. I almost wish there were like a sweeping bar in the level to tell me where the Memory Lake is. Ow. Don't worry. Here we go. This is it. Whoa. God. This game really is a trip. It's something else, man.
We've been waiting for you.
I see the devs from Crash Bandicoot watch a speedrunner beat the game in 10 minutes. That was... What?
You still have the trash can in the house?
Yeah, I guess so. I'll get to it eventually. What? Come on. Steph, there's plenty of times there's been things around that I've had to be patient with. Oh. What? It's just a nice trash can. A pleasant trash can. I suddenly get very stressed about life in Rona, and then I'm gonna fix it by smoking weed and eating paella? I don't know what that is. Okay. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna Google symptoms and decide if I have super cancer. That's always a good idea. A good mental management tool. That one got me. Okay, I can't... I approached that jump from the same angle a couple of times, and that droid keeps sniping me out of the air. I wonder if it'll be crackly again. I'm gonna guess yes. God damn it. Yeah. This doesn't... Oops. Oh, that's where Xbox came from. I see. It was the preset, that's all. You can afford to slow down at that point? You're already like 20 minutes ahead. Why, though? Why? Why would I slow down? Speed run. I haven't watched the Doom Eternal speed run yet. I need to check that out. Just a PS3... it's a PS3 theme on my original Xbox. That's all. Oh, Christ. Yeah, dick too big. Law of inertia. Once you get that thing moving. Okay, yeah, you can't be Anakin despite him being in the cover art. That's kind of weird. Any interest in playing the Ghost Runner demo? Yeah, actually. Should probably be playing that right now. Yeah, I feel the same way. I prefer the inbound speedruns, or 100% speedruns. Like, the ones where they kind of have to... I do like the artistry of trying to figure out how to skip as much of the game as possible, but it seems it's always a little more interesting to me to see them, like, have to actually play the game as quickly as possible. Star Wars is probably the only fiction with a power system where the kids are never just freaky strong. I guess you're right, yeah. There are, immaculate force people. But yeah, they don't seem like they're ever kids. I guess there was Anakin, but they had to use tools to measure him, and it was, like, his force powers were not apparent as a kid, really. Aside from him being a force Jesus baby. Oh, Jay Flay, hi, you're off for the night? Alright. Thanks for watching, man. Oh, that's not the way to go. How is that car so slippery? stop. Okay. Fuck! God, this game. Just gotta keep zigzagging, I think. If you run straight into an enemy, they can get you. Yamachiya! Yeah, you can't mix up your zigs and your zags, for sure. Gotta watch out for those.
We've been waiting for you.
That dude's consistent. What? Okay. And now this is the guy that keeps sniping me, so maybe I'll just pull a little lap here. Give him a little shot first. Fuck! Flow does not turn on a dime. There we go. Fuck off. Crab it! Shit! I wonder if they've been waiting for me. Yeah. Grace, this level's something else. Should have zagged. Yeah, didn't zig. Or I did zig. The zig was off, basically. It's worth it for the Yoda giggle.
Yamachiya!
Fuck! God damn it! I feel like you could eventually learn a route so that you never actually get hit by any of those guys. Because it's really like if you just jump straight at them, you'll eat the shot. How did I get this the first time? I'm so annoyed. I got it before and it just didn't hit the checkpoint. Now I'm down to one credit again.
Yeah!
All right. God damn it! I didn't zig or zag. Fuck. Okay. Checkpoint is up there. No! No! Alright, so. If you're. He doesn't turn in place, he turns like a tire. So, like. If you're not running. Yeah, if you hold run and turn around, he turns like a fucking tire. But if you're not holding run, then he will turn in place. Fuck you! God damn it. Alright, well, I learned something. 32-bit Ellison. Or 32-bit Ellison, thanks for the Prime sub. Yeah. Why wouldn't he turn in place? Why wouldn't he do that? What's up, Grace? You don't like seeing a big-ass annoying video game? Alright, I got it. I got the strats. I'm down to 0 credits, though. That's okay. I'm learning. At this point, just play Omicron? Kind of tempting, actually. I want to play Omicron. I've been wanting to for a while. I never got very far in that game because I didn't know how. But now that I'm older and wiser and have a big gamer brain, I think I could figure it out. Gets worse the further you get in the game. Well, the problem with this is that this level's so fucking long that the game crashes by the time I get to it. Ugh! Look at him. They're coming after me. Oh, you mean Omicron. My bad. It's always fun for, like, games that are poorly designed or not even finished to try and attempt a developer-intended playthrough of the game. Okay. Fuck you. Okay, here, I will actually kill this guy to try and reduce. Okay. Well, I don't need the checkpoint because I have 0 credit. Actually, no, wait, there's a credit later. Where did they. Oh, does the car come up if I kill these dudes? Maybe that's what I gotta do. Okay, car. I guess maybe there's only specific mans you have to kill. Holy shit, man. Oh, right. Give me that checkpoint! Give me that credit! God, fuck you! Just leave me alone! Leave me alone for 5 seconds! Okay. Okay, good. Credit acquired. We got this. She's gonna go pick up that health. My thumb is getting sore because the D-pad on the fucking DualShock sucks. It's really spongy and resistive. Holy fuck! Go away! Oh my god, okay. Yeah, now come all the little troll boys who specifically are here to fuck you up. Like. God fucking god damn it! Okay. Alright. Man, my hand hurts. This is so. Classic. Classic gamer. Okay, so there's still no sound effect that's repeating. The music's still playing. I don't think there were any more troll bots. I think it was just pretty straight to the end of the level, as I recall. There was that part where you have to fall off the bridge and land on the car. That sucked. Fuck you. Oh, God. He turned in the air! Jesus Christ. Oh my God. It's like one hit stops you absolutely cold. Shit. Oh yeah, you have to jump to one car and then jump back. Fox 2102. He's just one big tire. He is. God bless him. God bless our boy. Alright, then the car freaks out in the background. Can I just jump now? Probably? Interest in the Ghost Runner demo? Yeah, I need to play it. I didn't know there was a demo out. Oh god, that terrified me for a second. Mm-hmm. Actually, I might want to take care of this dude so I can do the drop. Alright. Oh, checkpoint. Got the timing for the sound cue pretty good. Look at that 3D though. Right, it was just this. Right. Clean it out a little bit. I can't see. Okay. I think it's fine. Grab it! You piece of shit! Don't! Okay, so he also turns in a circle when he's in the air. Which is the worst possible thing when you're asking people to platform! Fuck, and now I don't have any force power. Alright. Hey, Steven. I'm, in an interesting problem here. I'm trying to beat this trolly-ass game, okay. That also has even technical problems. Okay, this is the boss fight, right? Whew. There's no looping sound. Everything's fine.
We've been waiting for you.
All right.
We've been waiting for you.
Yeah.
for you.
Well, he's a large boy, huh? Final showdown. Oh wait, no, he summons a couple of his bros first. The music stopped. Fuck. Save state? I'm not on a... It's on a PlayStation. That's not a thing. I'm getting the authentic retro experience. Shoving me into the corner. All right. Yeah. I mean, the disc is really scratched, so it may be that. It may be just that. I think it's a hybrid of two things. I think if you play for too long, it eventually tries to read data from a scratched part of the disc and gets bad stuff. Yeah, buff the disc. I mean, I cleaned it. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe they still have disc resurfacers. Yeah, they do.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, maybe that's what I need to do. Yeah, they have that shitty hand crank, plastic piece of crap. Oh, it's battery operated. Well. Okay, yeah, maybe I'll invest further in beating properly beating power battles. Emulator? Nah, that's not fun. That's not fun at all. Nah. But yeah, it's on to another game. God damn it. 3 hours and I couldn't beat a single stage. Okay. Is this game worth it? It's a matter of pride now. It's a matter of pride. Gamer pride. Okay. Yeah, I'll switch up to... Everyone threaten to unsub if I don't beat Jedi Power Battles? Well, now I gotta do it. There's no question anymore. Okay. Yeah, I'll swap over to Doom for a little bit. I do have a call at 5:30, which is in 45 minutes. So I'll play Doom for a little bit. Probably die a lot, because, again, I'm a little rusty again. But then, Doom. And then, yeah, we'll be playing The Old Republic later. You're not angry enough? Sorry. Yeah, I don't rage. My 8-year-old cousin taught me that real epic Fortnite gamers call it a Vic Roy. That's nice. Well, I'm glad that both you know and that you share that knowledge with us. So yeah, okay. Brief pause. I'm gonna take this trash can back outside. Why'd you have to read it? So I can share your knowledge with everybody. I guess it was already in there.
No.
Okay, see you guys in a second. Whew, I'm gonna go take a walk.